My Facebook feed is constantly filled with memes spouting nonsense about President Obama. But ever since Obamacare has gone into effect, they've really turned up the heat. Today, I saw a meme on a Facebook page called Freedom Works. Here's the meme now. Now, this is obviously taking a stab at Obamacare and is just an attempt from this ultra-conservative page to stir the pot and keep all of their Fox News-watching followers in complete ignorant bliss. A lot of liberals often criticize people on the right for acting like bigoted racists for their remarks about our president. Some even go so far as to call them traitors. But anytime you confront a Republican about this behavior, they're outraged, and they call you a presumptuous pig for even entertaining the notion that racism still exists in society today. I mean, these are God-fearing, hard-working, loving people who are loyal to their country, right? The other thing that most liberals notice about Republican behavior is that they seldom have their facts straight before blurting out an argument against the president's choice in policy. Worse still, even when they're presented with actual facts on the matter from reputable sources, they still maintain their paranoid, delusional positions and reject any information contrary to what they personally believe to be true. Sounds like religion, doesn't it? Republican people will insist that they're as intelligent and rational about politics as the most extreme liberal you can find. If you question their relying on false information for arguments, it's you that's the idiot, and you're just brainwashed by liberal terrorist propaganda. Well, let's look at some of the comments under this meme to see how these respectable, loving, kind-hearted Republicans are reacting to Obamacare, and how us liberals have just got it all wrong when we accuse them of behaving like bigoted racists. Put an end to him. Take your shared responsibility and shove it. Fuck him. Screw you, goat humper. Yup, he's funneling all the tax money to the Islamic terrorists. I'll be glad when your ass is gone. I'll share that with you, laugh out loud. I'm gonna enjoy watching him hang for what he's done. Hang the bitch. Put an end to Obama.
I think we should just put an end to him.
Communism. Criminal. Fuck nut. Enjoy your time behind bars. Piece of trash. So sick of seeing this ass clown's face.
Screw you, thug.
Where do I sign to put an end to him? As in hang the garbage till he's dead. Fucking bastard. Nazi.
Look, I know there are left-wing extremists out there who are far more aggressive in stating their positions than the average liberal, and some of them may not exercise the best judgment when presenting their arguments, but you never see anything like this. These people are so far beyond hopeless, and it scares the shit out of me that these kinds of people are probably 60% of our voters. These people treat their politics the same way they treat their religion. They don't care about what's actually true, they only care about what they personally believe to be true. Anything outside the bounds of their noggin is irrelevant. Ever since Barack Obama was sworn in back in 2008, the right-wing extremists have made no secret about how they feel. In reality, they sit in front of Fox News every day, get their daily dose of bullshit, and then go out into the world spreading what they've been told to believe as their own personal opinions. The other thing that bothers me about the right wing is ever since a Democrat got elected to office, the Republicans haven't really done anything to actually help the American people. They've been too busy trying to stop any and everything that President Obama has been trying to do, even when most of what he's been trying to do is for their benefit. But what do I know? Let's give them the benefit of the doubt. What is this shared responsibility tax anyway? Well, according to the IRS website, starting January 2014, you and your family must either have health insurance coverage throughout the year, qualify for an exemption from coverage, or make a payment when you file your 2014 federal income tax return in 2015. Many people already have qualifying health insurance coverage and do not need to do anything more than maintain that coverage in 2014. Basically, what this is saying is that if you already have health insurance, shut the fuck up! This shared responsibility tax doesn't even apply to you! The IRS goes on to say, qualifying coverage includes coverage provided by your employer, health insurance you purchase in the health insurance marketplace, most government-sponsored coverage, and coverage you purchase directly from an insurance company. So if you already had health insurance through your employer or you purchased health insurance prior to this going into effect, you don't owe anything! Nada! Not one red cent! Additionally, if your proposed monthly premium is going to be more than 8% of your estimated annual income, you don't owe this tax either. If your annual income for 2014 was less than the federal poverty level, which is about $21,000 for a family of two, you don't owe this tax either. If you already have insurance, you don't pay the tax. If your annual income is below the federal poverty line, you don't pay the tax. In fact, the only way you're paying this tax is if you make enough to afford health insurance and just choose not to have it, in which case, you have no one to blame but yourself. So, what are you people bitching about?